jump in. I can't tell you how much I thank you for jumping in and also sharing such great edgy stuff. It is Secrets from the Inside when we hear from Captain James McCormick. Go ahead, sir.
Well, it is edgy because it used to be the standard normal discussions that we used to have all the time. You know, what we're talking about right now, this isn't, we used to sit around. You know, we had a plan. I had a neighbor that lived next to me just recently and have another one now. We had a plan. We looked out for each other. Oh, I'm going out of town. Okay, I'm going to keep an eye on your house. Okay. You know, when I was going through rehab, you know what I mean, through for being wounded in Iraq, I couldn't cut my grass, you know what I mean? And that was a hard thing for me. And I'm telling you, I am a man that has a little bit of pride. It's a healthy pride, though. It's not an unhealthy pride. But 9 o'clock at night, man, I hear a lawnmower firing up. My neighbor's out because that's the only time he could. He's out there with his headlights on his riding lawnmower cutting my grass, okay? And his kids, when my wife was pregnant, they would run over and help my wife carry in groceries. That's the kind of community that we had. Now, it's not that with all the neighbors. We got some neighbors that don't do that, but we have a few that still do. And we'd come over, we'd talk guns. We'd clean guns on our back porch. You know what I mean? We'd talk about, you know, what's going on in the world. We'd have good civil conversations. He had two daughters and a son. You know, I would teach my sons, my daughters, his daughters, my sons, how to do things like build a fire. I'll never forget this. I taught every one of them how to build a fire without matches. You know what I mean? Taught them how to do it with magnifying glasses, taught them how to do it with sticks, taught them how to do it with strikers, taught them how to do it with flint and steel, taught them how to, you know, to make one of those devices, with the bow. And it worked, man. And you know, the look on their face when they start to see that smoke come out, they made fire. They know how to make fire, you know, to this day. And then we would talk about where to get water from. Taught them how to make a solar steel, Greg. So with a piece of plastic and a can and a hole in the ground and some grass thrown in there. And, you know, the sun, you know, would cause condensation. And you'd put a little pebble in the middle of it, and that condensation would soak down in the middle and drop, you know, drop of water in a can. Now, it doesn't get you a lot of water, but it's enough to keep you alive. You know what I mean? If you can't find water anywhere else, you know, how to get water with the daggone sponge off of the leaves and off of the grass in the mornings. I watch my dogs out there. My dogs are smart enough to do that, Greg. They walk out in the morning, there's frost on the ground. They're out there licking that ground, man. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Can you, this stuff you're talking about, James, this is mandatory. This should be mandatory learning for, again, young people.